the experiment.
Okay. So, do you know the charges of how, do you know how the periodic is set up, how the charges are set up on the periodic table? The periodic table is like beautiful.
A little bit.
Okay, let's look at the periodic table. Bring that up. Okay, so let's look at sodium. Okay, sodium is in the S column, first column, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so because sodium, okay, so know that you are highly attracted to make a reaction in your S column, and you highly attracted to make all the way over in your P column. You know that, right?
All right.
Okay. So when you're looking at sodium and what sodium is more likely to bond with, you're going to thank you. I'm sorry. When you're looking at sodium and what sodium is more likely to bond at, and what kind of bonding reaction it will cause, you're looking at the electronegativity. Am I saying that right? Yeah. Right. Okay. So you're looking at sodium, and sodium is immediately bonded into that carbon, right?
All right.
Okay. Right. But okay. So when they come together, the inner bonds, if it was an outer bond, what would that be?
I don't know.
Okay. So, what kind of bonds do hydrogen bonds make? What kind of bonds are hydrogen bonds?
I don't know.
Okay, so hydrogen bonds are like weak bonds, right? They easily break. Yeah, you can easily break them up. Covalent bonds are a little more stronger bonds. They're more so like the interlocking of two molecules touching. So think of your orbital, right?
Okay,
so think of draw a carbon. I don't know if you're going to see my paper, but we're going to try it, okay? So how many valence electrons do carbon have?
One. Let me see. You said do carbon?
Mm-hmm.
Four.
Okay. So carbon has four. How many do nitrogen have? Sodium.
Sodium has 11? Oh, one. Is it 11?
No, it has one.
Oh.
Okay, so the first way you got to look at it is when I'm looking at the periodic table, starting with lithium, I'm gonna look over hydrogen right now. But I'm gonna start over there with hydrogen. I'm gonna say that's one. Mm-hmm. That's one valence electrons there. Then go to the another one where beryllium is. That's two. Skip all the transitional metals, and then start three with boron, four with carbon, five with nitrogen, six with oxygen, seven with what's on the other side? It should be fluorine, and then eight with your high your noble gases, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So you see how you get your valence electrons, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so when you're looking at two highly active, what is the goal for every electron on the periodic table?
To combine, connect.
Huh?
To connect.
To connect for what purpose? What they want to be like?
They want to be one.
They want to be like the noble gases, right? Noble gases, they don't really care to connect with nobody, do they?
No.
Why?
Because I don't know.
Okay, so you know that every atom has two electrons in the inner shell, right?
All right. Yeah.
That's the normally they have two electrons on the outer shell, and the valence electrons tell how many. Two electrons in the inner shell, and then the valence electrons tell you how many electrons are in the outer shell. You understand that, right?
Yes.
That's why carbon says it has six, but because two is in the inner shell, the other four is in the outer shell, so that's why we only count the four.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. So when you're looking at carbon, this is a generic cartoon. This is carbon. Can you see that?
Yeah.
Okay, that's carbon, right?
Mm-hmm.
And everything else under carbon, thallium, or germium, and tin, and lead, all of them have the four valence electrons in the outermost shell.
Okay.
Okay. So when we're looking for, when you're looking at every element on the periodic table, they're all trying to be like the noble gases, either have eight where they're completely happy, or they don't have none in their outer shell where they gave an electron so they can be happy. So when you're looking at, now I'm going back, when you're looking at the S orbital, when you're looking at one and two, where hydrogen is and where beryllium is and magnesium is, and you're looking at oxygen and fluorine, those are too highly because they almost at eight.
Yeah.
So hydrogen and lithium, they like, all we need to do is get rid of one. And then fluorine is like, all we need to do is add one more to it and we could be happy. You get it?
Yeah, I get it.
Okay. So when you're looking, this is the easiest way I can explain it. So when you're looking at if I put some chemicals in the container, if I put some magnesium and and sodium and fluorine and carbon into a beaker, and we're not talking about it exploding because some of these things are explosive, but if in the normal states, if all these were not explosive and you put them in a beaker, they would still go to what would give them that eight, the first. Get it?
Yeah, I get it.
Okay. So sodium is going to immediately want to pair up with chloride.
Mm-hmm.
Do you understand why I'm saying that? Do you understand why? Okay. Do you know what periods and table, what periods and columns is?
A period in the column, yeah.
Okay. All right. So because you're looking now you're counting down. So mind you, how many periods and how many columns? Come on, you got this.
Is it eight periods?
Is it eight periods?
Yeah, I'm asking.
Okay. So there, So when you're looking at the periods on the periods and columns on the periodic table, you're looking at the periods is what goes down. The columns is what goes across. So there's 18 columns and there's 7 periods. Now, the reason why you probably counted 8 is because you're counting hydrogen. Mm-hmm. Am I correct?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. So when you're counting, I can't even see you. So when you're counting hydrogen, we're not gonna count that. We go start at, no, you count hydrogen. Hydrogen is 1, lithium, that role is 2, sodium, that role is 3, potassium, that role is 4. And counting on down like that. So we count down. So that period is going to what, when it goes to bond with something, it's a first ideal thing that is going to bond with is something that's in that same period with them. That's why sodium, instead of going to fluoride first, is going to go to chloride first. Do you understand that?
Okay, yeah.
Okay.
Miss Lane, can you help him create one model? Because I don't think he has a lot of time.
Okay. Okay, so let's go to the one model. Okay, so I don't know this software, but let's pick up my your sodium. Oops. That's lithium. All right. So now sodium is trying to bond. It's trying to bond with carbon. But mind you, sodium is at a +1 and carbon is at a +2. Sodium is at a valence electron number of 1 and carbon is at a valence electron number of 4. So when you put sodium and carbon together, initially you're going to get how many valence electrons?
If you put sodium and carbon,
right.
Oh, you get 4?
You're going to get 5.
Is there a way for you connect it and then you see it on the software? Yeah. Or?
Yeah, you can connect
okay.
it.
Okay, go ahead. Add the carbon.
Okay, you that's understand? How you create it.
Okay, now you see what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
But what the problem is that they not happy.
Yeah.
Right? Because carbon still needs some more and sodium still needs some more.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So sodium saying, hey, I like bonding with you, but hey, I need some, we need to make a stronger connection. So now take one of those, sodium and connect it to the carbon again. You get it?
Yeah.
Okay. So now is carbon happier?
Yeah.
Now, does this represent the original chemical reaction from your problem statement?
I mean, from this one, hold on.
So make sure you're following her.
Okay, we gotta go back. Okay. So but here's the thing. So right, this is what it would look like if carbon was only connecting, sodium and carbon was only connecting to each other to make each other happy. But sodium and carbon is not connected to only each other,
mm-hmm.
right? So now, instead of making one bond with one weak bond with sodium and carbon, you take one of them away. Take one of the sodiums away.
You can't do that.
Oh, you can't. Okay.
I can't read.
Throw the whole molecule.
Yeah.
Now pull out the carbon and one sodium. And now make it make a double bond with each other. Move the other one. Yep.
I can't do that.
right there, and then take that other one and move it to the oh, it won't let you do it?
No.
No, you can't bond carbon with carbon. You only can bond carbon with sodium. Okay, now the next thing is CO, because we're making hydrogen peroxide. So you're going to need oxygen too.
Oxygen? Okay.
I'll put it on the other side. Okay, so oxygen is still not happy, right? Mm-hmm. So now you need to get another oxygen and bond it to there.
All right.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay, so we almost got a carboxyl group, but that's not what we're trying to get. Now you got, you're still not balanced out, so you need to add your hydrogens. Your hydrogen, you only got one. Put it at the top of carb.
Okay,
so now we still not happy, right? Because mm-hmm. How many we got? We got carbon, got 2, 4, 6. They got 7. Carbon got 7. You got one of your oxygen is happy, and one of your carbons is happy, and one of your carbons is not happy, and one of your oxygens is not happy. Do you see that?
Yeah.
Okay. So now we have to bond the carbon. We got to bond and balance the equation. So the next thing is NaCO. I'm sorry. I'm trying to remember what it was. What's the thing? NaCO. Okay. NaHCO3. CO3. Okay, go back.
So you need another oxygen?
Yeah, you need another oxygen, you need to add another carbon.
Are you understanding what she's doing, sir? Because she's explaining it pretty well. I just want to make sure.
Yeah.
Okay, all right. I'm going to be silent and let her do what she does.
You said add another oxygen and another what?
Carbon.
All right.
No, thanks, Ms. Lane, for the help.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Which one do I connect this to?
I would connect that to oxygen.
Oh.
So, okay, so you're going to ultimately make CO3
mm-hmm.
as a byproduct. CO3 gas.
CO3. I'm trying to connect this to carbon.
Wait. Over here. Yeah. Not that one.
Oh.
The other one that you just pulled up.
This one?
Mm-hmm. All right. Now here's the thing. We still don't have another sodium.
Mm-hmm.
Right, because it was two times Na.
Right.
So where do I put this?
You go put that next to that carbon, that first carbon. Right there.
Mm-hmm. Still got three since that's unsatisfied.
Okay. So now you got Na2 HCO3. Mm-hmm. And you have a byproduct CO2. and you have a byproduct of CO3.
Hold on.
Is that right? Wait, can I see your
question? I made the model already for each of these. I just need to explain it.
Okay, let me see. Let me see. Okay, explain it to me. Let me see what you did. Explain to me what you did.
Do you have the original image? Because when I tried to blow it up, sir, I couldn't expand it. Do you have the original images? Because it's really hard to see.
No, I can zoom in though.
Okay, yeah, zoom in so she can see what you made, and she can probably tell you better. There you go. So all of his non-connections are satisfied. You just need to explain.
But see, on here, this is what I was saying. On the picture that you're showing right here, oxygen is double bonded.
Yeah.
You couldn't make a, when I was trying to get you to make a double bond, you couldn't make a double bond.
Oh.
Yeah. I see that. He has, so, in the first one, only one NA. And then the second picture, two NAs. So right. Are you explaining each part of the chemical process?
You have to, because what when you heat it, they break apart, and so you'll have water, you'll have CO2 give off, those are byproducts, and ultimately you'll have NaCO3. So NaCO3 is one thing. Water is another thing. So you're going to have three different structures at the end. You started off with one structure, and when it got heated up, it's going to break into three structures. You understand?
I see what you're saying. All right, so the first segment does not look correct because you only got one NA. But your other three, I didn't get a chance to check them. They have to match NA to CO3 as a assumed solid. H2O, is that a gas? I thought that was a liquid. And CO2. So your other three should represent those three components. Your first component should be exactly 2NaHCO3. But you're missing in that first diagram an Na. So before you explain it, I know you say you did it, but you got some errors in there because the first diagram doesn't look right. Let's, like, if you zoom in again, what is that other one that's connected to the top? Is that an NA or is that something else?
Wait, let me say something to you, Mr. Hunter.
All right.
So you gotta know that when it breaks off, when it's heated up, the stronger covalent bonds are last to break. Hydrogen bonds go break off fast, so your anything that's connected to your H2O is going to break off real fast. Okay. So that's how you go. So when you heat it up, you want to make sure that you showing in your structure where the weak bonds were. That's your hydrogen bonds, your van der Waals bonds. Those bonds are going to break off fast. So when you construct your structure, show that bond, that's where that came from. That whole part where the H2O is gonna come off. And that's because they don't have a double bond. But when you're talking about covalent bonds are stronger. So when it heats up, they're going to break off from whatever is attached to it, but they go stay together. And that's why NaCO2 stays together.
So if I may ask, the two processes we're concerned with here, the first image should represent the products and the second should represent the reactants. Is that correct?
Right. After it was heated up, what happened?
Right. So the first one, sir, you do not have constructed correctly because it does not represent the products.
All right.
You're missing an NA in there somewhere. So you want to check that. And then the other three should represent the reactant process that she's speaking of. So you got to go back. I know you want to give the explanation, but you want to give a correct explanation. I want you to work that first image correctly and then put that in there with her.
Okay. Because
I think she's limited on time too. And then the other three will just be Na2CO3. That'll be your second image. Your third image will be H2O.
Yeah.
And then the last image will be CO2. But your first image does not look right. So you might want to look at that.
Okay, and the first thing, and you gotta also know that each one makes certain bond breaks. So you, I already gave you one repeatedly over and over. So you know that one made a hydrogen bond. So hydrogen bonds are weaker bonds. So hydrogen bonds break off, and that's how you got the byproduct of water, right? All right. So then covalent bonds, they're a little stronger, but they're not as strong as ionic bonds. So ionic bonds last, they make a stronger bond. So you, and that's how you get the NaCl3.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And then when, but me telling you the answer, you still got to be able to, do you see why I'm saying that? That's why I was breaking off what is more likely to bond with what, because I want you to see the electron negativity and how they pull towards each other.
Yeah.
You saying yeah, but I'm not sure that you understand.
Yeah, so I have to restart. I have to redo the first image because I forgot an A. Right, and then.
But do you understand why?
Because. No, I do, but I don't remember what you said.
Okay, so where are you hazy at?
The Y part.
The white part.
The why, like why.
Okay. Okay. So that's all. The why part comes from knowing not just your periodic table, what, but the reactions of the atoms on the table, and knowing what type of bonds they would call.
So I sent you a stoichiometry video, and mm-hmm. she's talking about balancing equations. That's kind of the why part, because you got to do some calculations, which is based on what she's talking about, to make sure you have a balanced equation. I know you said they're balanced already, but there are some in-between calculations that you're not seeing yet. And that's what she's trying to fill in the blanks for. You were saying, Ms. Lane?
Okay, so that's what I'm trying to explain to you. And I'm trying to think of the most simplest way. That's why I was telling you. Now, you're looking at overall, you're looking at every element, every Na, H, Cl, carbon, and oxygen. All of them are trying to reach 8. But when you put them together, you also have to, the beautiful thing is you already got the balanced equation. So you have to put them together where you can show where they broke off and just explain why they broke off, because covalent bonds do this, ionic bonds do this. You understand?
Oh, yeah.
So can you work through one of them so we can make sure you got it, and then you can try. Once you get the models done, the explanation is easy. But
right.
You're having a hard time understanding how the models come together.
Yeah, because when I was telling them to put it together, he couldn't see it.
Yeah, well, that's because his original model, see, that's kind of close. He got 2 NAs there, but his first one is not, it's not showing the 2 NA. Because you understand that 2 multiplies into all the chemicals there.
So right.
That's two NAs, two oxygens, and 2 carbons, and about 6 oxygens. That's 2 times 3. So right. If you look at your diagram, you'll see you only got 1 NA. You didn't take care of mm-hmm. that coefficient, which is 2. In that diagram, I see there, you kind of got it.
Mm-hmm.
But you need to make it that first process correct before you explain anything.
Right. And we need to change hydrogen and put hydrogen on oxygen.
Right, he has no hydrogens.
And two hydrogens on oxygen.
I'm going to do this.
Yeah, just take your time. It's like putting a puzzle together, but you'll get it.
2 hydrogen.
On 1 oxygen. Okay, so now you know nothing else can bond to them hydrogens. They completely happy.
Yeah.
Okay. Right. So yeah. So now you gotta, now you buy one of the hydrogens. Now man, you not hydrogen, one of the sodiums with a carbon. Leave one of the sodiums alone, Bill, and bind the other one with a carbon.
All right.
And you go bind that carbon with one of the oxygens. Wait. Now we have to put these molecules together.
Okay.
So now that you're not putting it together, so you gotta put yeah.
Oh, you can't do it. Yeah. Oh, you can't do it. Yeah. Like this. Want these to connect?
Yeah, go ahead.
All right.
I want to flip this model, but go ahead.
Now what would I do?
You need another. I'm having a hard time with this model. Let me draw it out first.
Are you, Miss Lane, sketching out something you're supposed to do?
I'm
seeing you. You sketch it out. Maybe he'll see better.
What? Yeah, because me trying to see, me trying to do it with his computer is, I'm not that learning. Yeah,
it's new software. Sir, can you change the screen with the chemical reaction so she can write it down? Now the actual problem set. And I think that, there we go. Leave it there for a second so she can construct it for you. And then maybe with the software, we can figure out how to get the first diagram correct.
Okay, can you see this?
Yeah.
Can you do that? Can you create that? I need, because I need a double bond on oxygen.
All right, I'll create it.
Thanks, Miss Lane. That's better. I can see that myself. Some people are visual creatures. Mm-hmm. Okay. So around carbon, there's a double bond of oxygen for what I saw she drew. And you can connect that oxygen to my man. Okay. All right, Miss Link, can you show your diagram again? I think he's getting closer. Okay. So I think he has a double bond of carbon.
Mm-hmm.
And now you need a bond to oxygen and hydrogen. And I think you had Na on there already.
Yeah, I have one.
Okay, yeah. Okay, so you got to follow her guidance on that.
All right. I'm pretty sure I got it. Now what?
Okay, so that's what you have starting off.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Okay.
That's your initial thing. Now but here the equation is not balanced.
Yeah, he's still missing Na, I think, and a few, and one more.
No, you're missing two things. Can you tell me what we're missing?
Na and hydrogen.
Right. Okay. So now what we need to do is add Na and hydrogen.
Is this helping you, sir, or no?
Yeah, it is a little more.
Yeah, because you was like, I was confused, but I think she's explaining this quite well.
So put Na on oxygen?
Yes.
All right.
No. Oh, I'm sorry. Put it on the carbon. Take that off.
I can't do that.
Oh, dang. I'm so sorry. Once it's bonded. I do not like this system.
Yeah.
What program is this?
I don't even know.
This is good because we're making progress, but but he's understanding. Don't feel bad, Miss Lane. I see what he's doing. He's getting it because he started off with I don't know what to do, but he's just recreate what you did and try to make sure all those red dots, those are the unsatisfied elements mm-hmm. she's talking about, and you know, just try to get back where you was. This is bad. You should be able to undo a step, but I guess not. Yeah, I see why you're frustrated.
Because you got to keep restarting every time. That's crap.
They should let you just undo a step. That's crazy. Okay, that looks like where you were. All right, Miss Lane, where does he connect this to?
Now connect that to, yeah.
All right, how does that look?
You got it.
Okay, so that's your first product. That's your first image.
Mm-hmm.
okay. not the image you asked. You may remove that from your explanation section and put that snapshot in there. And then you got to recreate the other, the reaction process with them other three pictures.
Okay.
So first get that. Yeah. I see what you're doing. Yeah. Great job, Miss Lane.
Do you guys want to take a screenshot? I think I'll take that. I was on a different computer when I was taking this.
Okay, so you can use Control Alt print screen or Control Print screen. You got it.
I don't have print screen.
Play with it to see which one better for your computer. Each computer has a different one.
So you got a laptop, right?
Yeah.
There should be a button on the keyboard that says Print Screen. P-R-T-S-E.
Not on this laptop.
Okay. How did you do it earlier?
Earlier I was using my other laptop.
Oh boy, okay. There is a way to do print screen on your laptop. I'm just not sure you know what button it is because it's on all computers.
Well, I guess it's like a PRT and then it's a space SC.
Yes, that's the button. You press it. I don't know if you have press function in it or just it. And then it'll go to the clipboard and then you can paste it into the new document.
Yeah, I know. I think. I'm gonna search it up.
So you might want to open a new Google Doc and see if you can paste it somewhere. Oh, he's typing it in. Never mind. How to take a screenshot. Okay. There's got to be a way to do it on your laptop. But that is the best first.
There's no print screen on this keyboard, though.
I'm sorry. You ain't got a print screen?
No, not on this laptop.
Huh. All right, so is there a print button in that application?
Wait. Yeah. I want to see this equation. I'm looking at it.
Can you go to the equation?
Well, he is. No. He was right where you need to
be. Okay.
Okay. I'm looking at. Oh, I don't like how it's set up. I want to turn around.
I know. It looks decent.
It looks strange. Okay. So I'm up here looking at it and I'm like, okay, so the Na with the oxygen and that's giving the negative charge. That's the ionic bond for the Na to the oxygen. Then I'm looking at that same oxygen bonded with carbon. And that's making it cool. And then the carbon is double bonded to an oxygen. See, it's not this is still not right.
It's not.
How? Why you can't? What's going on with you making double bonds?
I make a double bond.
Look at the last one that you made. You made a double bond. How did you do that with the last one? We're missing a double bond. That's a covalent bond because we got all weak bonds here.
Well, we got two hydrogens, two. So what am I missing?
Okay, so here's my thing. The carbon must be double bonded to an oxygen. And we don't have that.
Why don't we have it? We have carbon connected to three oxygens.
Right. But what I'm saying is
a triple bond, isn't it?
Oh no, they all single bonds. So carbon is supposed to be attached to three oxygens.
It is.
Carbon is attached to three oxygen. That's why I'm showing you here. See? Do you see that? Carbon carbon is in the middle. Carbon is double bonded to this oxygen. It's single bonded to this oxygen.
Yeah,
and it's single bond to this oxygen.
I get it.
I think that's a software issue because it looks like he got it though. Oh, don't throw it away. Don't throw it away.
No, throw it away because it's no good. It's not. How do you make double bonds on here?
I think I know how to do it.
So carbon, use carbon as your single, right? Mm-hmm. So the carbon is supposed to be double bonded. So take that and bond.
Like that.
Okay, right. Okay, now bond carbon to a hydrogen. Not to a hydrogen. Leave that alone. Don't all just right. Drop it. Now go give me another oxygen. All
right.
And bond that to carbon. Bam. Now go get me another oxygen. And bond that to the last carbon.
Okay.
Bam. Okay. Now give me that first oxygen at the top of carbon and connect that hydrogen that you got. Yep. Bam. Okay. Now take that other oxygen right there that's left and bond that to the Na. Bam. That's what it's gonna look like.
Yeah.
Okay, so are we good or what?
Yeah.
All right. You got your Victor Dance going, but I'm looking at the clock. So is he straight on the first diagram, Miss Lane?
That's the first diagram.
All right, so back to he said save image. There you go. I think you figured it out.
Yeah.
It didn't change. Where are you at?
Oh, it's right here.
Oh, it went down a page. You gotta shrink it and stuff. There you go. There you go. Did it go where it's supposed to go?
Yeah.
All right. Okay so
now go to the next one. No. In the same one.
You got it right. You got to fix all three of those.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. So that's Na2CO3. Let me see. Is that what that say?
Mm-hmm.
Na2CO3. Oh, yeah. That's right.
That's wrong.
Is that? Yeah. That's no. My only thing is carbon would. Okay. I will put carbon with oxygen, but I guess, yeah. Because it broke off, and then you got H2O, and then the other one, you got CO2-3. You got CO2?
Mm-hmm.
And the last one?
The last one?
Yeah.
Well, all right. What about the last two?
That's why I asked them. Yeah, that's CO2.
Yeah.
Okay, so he's straight on his first explanation?
Yeah.
Okay, so
do you feel confident in this first explanation?
No.
Oh, why? Goodness.
Because I got the mother vibe. So,
huh?
How do I explain this? So you said.
Okay. Okay, so
articulation.
I was explaining it to you earlier. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm now repeating.
Well, okay. I'm recording, so I'm gonna be sending this to you and Rufus. So everything she's explaining, just listen to it. And once everything processes, I will send a YouTube video to Rufus and you. So try to listen to what she's talking about and try to synthesize it. But if you still didn't get it, when I send the video, you have to play it back slowly to probably put in your own words what you think the answer is. Go ahead, Miss Lynn.
Okay. Now, when you're looking at sodium, I can't help but go back to the periodic table and electronegativity. When sodium and oxygen come together, sodium is going to be at a plus charge. Oxygen and so let's blow the picture up so you can see what I'm talking about. So we're talking about right where sodium is connected to oxygen. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. The sodium is at a plus one charge, right? Because it has one electron, it got one valence electron that's in the outer shell. All right. And then your oxygen that connects with the sodium it's at a net, it's at a minus one charge, right? So when they come together, they're going to make what kind of bond?
Type of bond.
Okay, so sodium is considered a what kind of metal?
Oh, is it a weak metal?
Have you ever heard of alkaline?
No.
And y'all on balancing equations?
Yeah, that's what I'm so confused about. We never learned it in school. Yeah. It's hard.
It's a lot of stuff you don't know. Yes. It's so many terms that you don't know. I feel like I'm rushing you through it. And okay, so sodium is at a plus one charge. Oxygen is normally at a minus two charge. But when you bonded that one oxygen with carbon, the one that's connected with sodium, it brought it to, before it got connected to sodium, it was at a minus one charge. Do you understand that?
Okay.
Okay, so when you get that plus one and that minus one together, do you understand that it made a ionic bond?
When you put the plus and the minus together, it made an iconic bond.
Okay. Ionic.
Ionic.
Do you understand that?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. So now when you look at the interaction between oxygen and carbon, what kind of bond is that?
Is it ionic?
Believe it or not, they are not ionic.
So I think the reason she's asking you of these questions is because they sound like classic questions in your class.
Yeah, ionic.
You kind of got to flesh that out, Miss Lane, because you're talking in the ether. This is going into your explanation. So what she's explaining are topics that are pretty much how your teacher wants you to explain this process goes. So you got to put that out there, Miss Lane. You can't talk in the ether. Break down how the explanation is going, because I think that's what he's looking for.
So the biggest thing is you got to know what ionic, covalent, and hydrogen bonds are. You don't know those definitions. So it's going to be hard for you to understand what I'm saying without understanding those definitions.
Okay.
I can say it to you 50 million times, but if you don't know the definitions, you're not going to be able to explain it to somebody else.
So I think the first step is for you to put in your own words what she's talking about, so you can type this up in a way that explains, was it 1, 2, 3, 4 images? And she's giving you terms that your teacher's going to be looking for in terms of how you can explain it. Do you understand what I'm saying or no?
Yeah.
Okay, so I don't know if she has explained it again, but pay attention to what she's asking. She's not asking you questions, and I'm listening, to confuse you. She's asking you questions because she's a science teacher and she's trying to get you maximum credit. So you got to think about what she's asking you. What is a covalent bond? What is ionic bond? All these things are science terms, I'm pretty sure, in your chemistry class, your professor or your instructor has talked about. So how would you start explaining? I would say, to start you off, image one, this happens, just to get you started. She's giving you the subject matter, the content, but I think you're having trouble with starting with what to say. So why don't you say in step one, products, because that's what we did, right? Mm-hmm. What happened there? And you can ask her for help on how to, you know, elaborate with technical terms on what happened.
Yeah. Because I don't know what the terms mean, so I wouldn't know how to explain.
Right. Well, that's going to take some studying on your part to understand it, because we're on a limited amount of time, and for every minute we're on here, I got to charge you. So I'm trying not to, you know, keep you too long. But while she's here, you need to explain the first image you made, the first product you made. So when she's saying this is a type of bond, you need to write it down and then express it in their explanation. And then you can explain image 2, 3, and 4 in a similar fashion as to what's happening. But when she's talking about those topics, you got a notebook or something next to you?
Yeah, I just got one, yeah.
So why don't you write down these terms she's talking about and use them for your explanation, and then later on, look it up on Google and find out what these mean and just get it down pat. Because I don't know if the teacher's going to come back and ask you what you meant or if you got to prove your work. So she can say everything and you can write it down, but if you don't know what it means, it's going to hurt you on the exam later on.
So did your teacher say anything to you about thermal decomposition?
Maybe before the
because that's what this is. This equation is thermal decomposition. Because that arrow in between the two NaHCO3, that arrow means heat. And because heat was added to this product, that's what happened.
I think he understands that, but how would he? Can you give him a generic explanation real quick so he can?
Okay. Okay. So you, I'm trying to figure out a better way to do
it. You got to water it down.
Okay. So when I had my baking soda, when I had my sodium bicarbonate, because that's what that is, right? So when I had my sodium bicarbonate.
Okay. Let him type that in, sodium bicarbonate.
Okay.
Or baking soda.
Okay, whatever. So he needs to start somewhere. So let's do it in chunks because you're moving real fast. Sodium bicarbonate or baking soda. Type that into your explanation. And you can edit this later on because it's not due until when? Tomorrow or?
Yeah.
Okay. So you got to slow her down because she will move out on you.
Okay.
So sodium bicarbonate, this is your step one, right?
Mm-hmm.
That's what you created in your product.
Sodium bicarbonate. How do you spell it?
Bicarbonate. BICARBONATE.
Okay. Is it E on their internet? Because that came up with an error.
Yes. Yeah. Well, at the end, it's E. Yeah.
All right. And then put a dash and then try explaining your own words what she's going to say.
So when sodium bicarbonate, when you add heat to it, it breaks down into sodium hydroxide.
Stop. Okay. So when you add heat to it,
yeah.
I'm trying to help you out, sir. You got to catch up with her. She will go.
Break down into.
It breaks down to sodium hydroxide.
There you go. Just gotta slow it down so you can get it done. All right, you gotta correct that because I see it. There you go.
Yeah.
Okay. So just slow her down. Ask a question.
Okay.
She's a teacher. She's gonna unload on you. Ask a question so you can synthesize information for your understanding. Because once we're off the phone, we can't help you. So slow her down and ask what you need so you can fill this out. And you should label this step one because you got three more steps to explain.
I'm sorry. So not hydroxide. Take that hydroxide. Just sodium oxide.
Sodium
oxide plus oxide is O. O-X-I-D-E.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Sodium oxide plus Carbon dioxide. And water.
Water.
There you go.
Okay.
Is that all of step one or no?
That's the whole process.
Okay.
That's everything that he got up at the top.
That's not what I was asking for. I was asking for him to break down in steps each image. So that's like actually step five, I guess. Because okay. Step one is the first image, step two is the second image, step three is third, and fourth is the last, and then fifth is what you said, right?
So this is what I'm saying. The first picture is a picture of sodium sodium bicarbonate by itself.
Okay. So maybe you want to come to where sodium bicarbonate is at the beginning of sodium in your sentence, hit enter. So come to sodium bicarbonate in your explanation.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, no. The whole sentence is gonna come down.
Oh wait, no, the directions. Look, I'm reading the directions. It says use the modeling software to present each of the chemical reactions from part one. As you create the reactions with the modeling software, draw a molecule model of the reaction below, then explain what happens in the reaction using the following terms: atom, molecule, bond, and...
I know, I saw that. So what did he do wrong, I guess? Because I saw that. That's why I was saying the bonds and everything you were talking about. Yeah.
So let's go break it down in the simplest form. I told you when you was making number one, mm-hmm. Okay, don't erase that. Just make another step one.
Okay,
so all you doing, they asking you to just tell it. So you're taking an atom, the atom sodium, which is an atom, right?
Yeah.
The atoms, she wants you to use the term atom, okay? Right? So you're going to take the sodium atom, the atom sodium, or have you speak. You got to say it in your own term, your own words. And then you bond, you okay, so listen. And then you go bond it, you bond the sodium atom with a plus one charge. That's going to impress them. For plus one charge. It has a plus one charge. With a plus one charge.
What?
The sodium atom has a plus one charge. The sodium atom has a plus one charge.
One charge.
Okay. And bonds with a oxygen atom with a minus one charge. Whom is already bonded with a carbon at a zero charge, because there's no charge there between the oxygen and the carbon. And the carbon is double bonded with another oxygen.
Can you repeat that?
The carbon is double bonded with another oxygen. And lastly, and then the last place around the carbon, you have another oxygen that's bonded with hydrogen.
Is that what you want him to type, or is that what you were thinking?
No, that's the whole thing.
Okay.
There is another oxygen.
Oxygen.
Bonded with the hydrogen. Okay, now read that's it back if you want. Right? Yeah, that's step one. That's just stating that picture. Okay, now read it back. Do you understand it? Can you picture it in your ass and how it's bonded? Do it make sense?
The sodium atom has a plus one charge and bonds with the oxygen atom with a minus one charge, which is already bonded with a carbon. The carbon is double bonded with another oxygen. The last place there is another oxygen bonded with a hydrogen.
That sounds pretty correct.
That's exactly that picture.
All right, so.
So step two, you're going to do that same thing. We go step two, we're going to go to the next picture and we're going to break down what that picture states. After heat, so you want to say when heat, you want to make sure that step two, heat added, right? You just want to acknowledge heat was added. Okay, now step three is what you call a thermal decomposition. Okay, because the heat was added, you have a thermal decomposition, so you have a rearrangement of a molecule, of the molecules, right?
Mm-hmm.
A rearrangement of the molecule. S, because you're going to have more than one molecule. It's going to break, one breaks down into three, right?
Yes.
Okay, so now number four. So now we're telling what it is. So the first one is going to be, remember I told you, it's going to be sodium oxide. Okay. Mm-hmm. Now, sodium oxide is a sodium bonded to oxygen. Okay. Now we're going to the next one.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so the next one is you're going to have carbon dioxide. All right, you got carbon, you got H2O. So you could say another byproduct is H2O. Because that's what you're doing. You're making byproducts. Mm-hmm.
Another step?
Yeah, I would say that's another step. Okay. I would call it, it's not necessarily a step, but it's another thing that happened.
Well, I'm just trying to get maximum credit. And,
yeah.
I like how he has all the steps.
Yeah, so you don't want to say never, you just put step five. Okay. You always keep the same process. Keep it, keep it consistent.
Right.
So then you're going to have carbon dioxide, not another. Don't use carbon dioxide is going to form. Mm-hmm. So you're going to have, and because of the heat, that ionic bond is going to break, and because of the heat, you're going to have a carbon. The end result will be carbon dioxide.
Just make sure what you're saying you repeat because he's still typing it. The ionic bond is going to break. Did he get that right?
Yeah, I would have reworded it a little bit, but if that's how he talked, you can say you can start off with because of the heat, the ion bond from the solvent bicarbonate will break and form carbon dioxide.
That's the beginning of step five.
That's a cleaner way to say it.
Is that the
right? The way that step five is written, I would question if you understand what's going on.
All right. So what she's saying is go back to step five and at the beginning of carbon dioxide type what she just explained.
What did you just explain?
Okay. So you would say because of the heat, The ionic bond will break, forming carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide is your ending product.
Okay. Because of the heat, so delete carbon dioxide. Delete this part?
Yes. That's going to be the last word you're going to have.
Okay.
So delete everything all up into ionic. The before ionic. Not the duh. Type the duh back.
So because of the heat, the ionic bond is going to break?
Forming carbon dioxide.
Okay. And the reason I had you do it this way is so it's a systematic approach to understanding what you did. Because I think you got how many other reactions you got to explain?
How many more?
Okay. No, this is the last one. Now he's going
to
talk about.
He's got more to do. So I'm just making sure he has a procedure.
Yeah, but with this one, it can help me do the rest.
Right. That's why I said I wanted you to have a systematic approach to this so you can finish the rest. So is there a step six?
Okay. The step six is the water.
The
other byproduct.
The last sentence he made?
Yes.
So you're going to take step six and move the sodium bicarbonate dash when you move that up. Okay, and that, okay. So.
No. That's sodium bicarbonate. That's finally. That's the seven steps.
That's what
step.
I was asking. Okay, so it's seven steps.
Yeah.
Okay,
so sixth step is what?
The forming of water, H2O.
Okay.
Another byproduct. I always like to call it byproduct. The final byproduct is. But I don't know if your teacher gave you that word.
That's why I was trying to slow you down, because you're using college terms on them.
Yeah,
I need you to slow down. So wait, the forming of water, is that what this is called?
Okay, so that's the last thing that forms. So I'm trying to think of a word that the way that you can put it without me giving you my terms. I'm going to go back. The last thing or one of the other things that heat wind up making it, because the only thing you get is heat. So you could go say the final thermal decomposition, what resulted from, because I don't even know if you're really using that word.
So let's keep it simple. Is there, the know, final okay. step is the creation of H2O.
Yeah, the creation of
H2O. Because I know you overthinking it. The final step is the creation of H2O.
All right, so.
I'm going to help you out with that because we got to start wrapping this up.
No,
that goes with step six.
Oh, okay.
That goes with step six.
She was trying to come up with a way to say it simplistically, and she was giving you a collegiate way to explain it.
The final step
is the forming of H2O. Which is really a byproduct.
I know, but I don't know if they cover byproducts. I'm just looking at the terms above.
Yeah. Yeah, because she's giving...
I don't want to give
the forming of H2O. From the forming of H2O with the hydrogen and the hydrogen atom and two oxygen atoms.
Okay, so you're explaining the molecules. You're explaining the atom, let's say.
Well, the hydrogen atom...
And two oxygen atoms.
That's
not right. And an oxygen atom. Just put an oxygen.
I was going to ask you about that. It's H2O. Okay. So it's two hydrogen and one oxygen.
Take away the two. Take away the two and just put an oxygen.
And you got to put a two by the hydrogen atom. So it's two hydrogen atoms and an oxygen atom. Okay, and then an oxygen atom.
Atom.
All right, and then a step seven, is that correct?
Step seven is completely correct.
Okay, so put a period at the end of it, sir, and I think it's as far as we can take you because I got to follow up with Rufus on if you need further help. But I want you to do this for all of the rest of your setups.
Okay.
Set up your diagrams first. And then try to explain what she's got going on. I'm going to share with Rufus, Ms. Lane's contact info. So okay. In case you get stuck tonight, you can reach out to her again if need be. Mm-hmm. But I got to follow up with him as to how he wants to go, because this is exactly the procedure, I think, to get best credit.
Wait. Number four don't sound right. Sodium oxide is a sodium bonded with oxygen. Okay, but a sodium atom bonded, put more atoms in it. He wants you to use the terminology up at the top.
Okay.
I'm trying to look. We need to add molecule. Okay, so step one, the sodium atom has one that, all that's true. That is another hydrogen atom, at the hydrogen, at the step one, at the very end,
mm-hmm.
which made the sodium bicarbonate molecule. Because I'm trying to add the terminology she's thinking. Sodium bicarbonate molecule. All right. There was heat added, breaking. So go to step two, mm-hmm. breaking. Okay, so added, breaking sodium bicarbonate molecule into three smaller molecules.
You said there's heat adding, breaking sodium bicarbonate
molecule. Into three break,
two, three
smaller molecules.
I think she said into.
Okay.
Yeah, into three smaller molecules.
Oh, so I do a little correction. There you go, and fix your grammar. Okay.
Now let me go back, because I'm trying to reread, baby. I'm trying. I like to get A's. Okay. Okay. And because the heat is added, there is a rearrangement of molecules. That is so correct. That's where your rearrangement word came in. And number four, sodium oxide is a sodium bonded with oxygen. Okay. All right. And then let me see. I'm just reading. Okay, number four is two sodium. Okay, sodium oxide is two, not a sodium. So say two sodiums bonded with the oxygen. Yep. All right.
Bonded.
All right, let's go down to the next one. Wait, let me look. Because of the heat, the ionic bond is going to break, forming carbon dioxide, forming a carbon dioxide molecule. Forming a carbon dioxide molecule. Okay. And the final step is a form of water with two hydrogen atoms and a oxygen atom. Sodium bicarbonate, when you add heat, is breaking down into sodium oxide plus hydrogen oxide and water. There it is.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I'm okay with that.
Are you fine with this? Okay, because I gotta start logging out. So take this procedure, sir, to mm-hmm. every situation and mm-hmm. take your time. Again, okay. I'm gonna download this recording and I'm gonna send it to you and Rufus,
mm-hmm.
so you can review it. And then I'm gonna also have her contact info, so you know if you guys work something out, she can help you out further. Okay.
All right.
Okay. Do you have any questions? Do you understand?
Yeah, I'm understanding that. And when I re-hear it, I understand it better.
Okay. Well, I gotta get off the phone with you guys so I can send that to you all, okay? All right. Thanks, Ms. Lane. Sir, I'll be in touch with you in a moment, okay?
All right, thank you.